we as human being in Pakistan, whenever you, if you are from the government of Pakistan, if you see the government of Pakistan, if you see the condition of this country, you should be very sensitive. Otherwise, you cannot leave this country. If Prime Minister Imran Khan is telling you some image that one father with his two children, one daughter probably and one boy, under some underpass in such coldness, aur puri raat wo wahan pe guzarta hai, how we are, mighty heart we have that we ignore those people. So that's why we being human and call ourselves that we are humans, you can make a shelter homes for them. So that's how he started this shelter homes. So when you're leading this climate ministry, climate change ministry, those, you know, running for the old ministries that you will have more power, water and power, then communication ministry, petroleum ministry, when you can make a lots of money. But sensitive people who have human hearts, who can think for other people, can lead the climate ministry. Because it's directly you're talking to the people. So when they have water or clean water, Mr. Theo said that it takes 1 hour or 2 hours. Unfortunately, in Dera Ghazi Khan, there are areas where women go for one, it's called gada or matka pitcher. To take one pitcher, they travel like 4 to 6 hours a day. And I met a woman who lost a baby while she was going on that way to carry that water. And a boy lost his life because that route or that path was so difficult in mountain areas while he was driving a bike for one glass of water. He lost his life through the accident. And here we're just buying mineral waters. A day will come, you will not be even able to buy a mineral water. Because in Pakistan, things are for granted. We take things for granted. Muft ka maal hai, maal ghanimat. We just take them and we just use them, you know, and just throw them. Just because we know that we are not going to be accountable. We are accountable. Whatever we use, we should be accountable. Here in a cabinet meeting, I approved another thing when I came here in my ministry. And I am going to work with my ministry, with the good brains of my ministry, that is WATRA, Water Table Regulatory Authority. Inshallah, for the first time, we are going to regulate the water table in Pakistan. Because in cities like Lahore, where we used to get water under the ground for 50 or 25 feet, it has gone lower than more than 300 feet. It's just because anybody can come and pump the water. Nobody asks them. Same here with the tube wells. Thousands of tube wells are in Pakistan. They are not regulated because there is no mechanism. Because baap ka maal hai na, jisne jidhar bhi istemal kar liya. And those who knows about the agricultural land, and we have water-based economy, because I am from that people. What we do, this is my land of some acres, we pierce the earth, and we just pump the water. And then after some time, we see ke kam paani aa raha hai. So we go and make another one, another tube well, and then another one. No, there's no check and balance. And in the world, it is like that. If you pierce the, you know, the earth, there are three layers of the earth. Pehle sand hai, phir niche chikni mitti hai, chikni mitti ke niche paani hai. The chikni mitti, which is actually wo purifier hai, jo paani upar se jata hai, wo niche jo hai, wo purifier ke niche jata hai. So when you pierce the water, wo drain karte hain aap paani, aur phir aap usko unclose karke chhod dete, the arsenic water goes down. Cancer usi se pehlta hai. Isi tarah ye sare bimariye jo hoti hai. So we under the ministry, inshallah, going to make this water table regulatory authority because we are accountable. You cannot take things for granted. Same is with Fata, when Mr. Theo talked about him. When we always talk about that we want clean water, Somewhere in Pakistan, people do not even have water. That's another question, that you have good or clean drinking water. We do not have any water actually in Pakistan. Just because it must be people from here, from Balochistan and all these people must be, you know, in Balochistan or in the south area, south Punjab. Khushk sali jisko bolte, kehat sali, it has started actually. Jahan pe 3-4 lakh ka ek peter lagta tha, it has gone more than 40 to 50 lakhs. Kyunki Balochistan mein zameen ka pani itna niche chala gaya. Just because maybe in Punjab, we are using lots of water without any regulatory. Same in South Punjab, where I belong. When I went there, when I started my politics, every morning when I used to wake up in the morning, when I used to read the newspaper, this is say that the girl has been raped or the child has been raped because she or he went for open defecation. And every time I used to say, why can't we build washrooms for them? There was the only solution. When a child and when a woman goes out for open defecation, you make them vulnerable to those people. And many of you people maybe know the story of Mukhtara Mai. It's the black spot on the face of Pakistan. And it started just because her brother or somebody's sister were at the same time walking in the fields for open defecation. So they were vulnerable and somebody accused of them, you know, being related to each other. And you know then what happened to Ms. Mukhtara. So it is not only a need, it's even a dignity that we are talking about. So when we are going to our homes, we have good washrooms or washrooms, but think of those people. Mr. Thieu said, I think that's more than like 20 to 22 lakhs. And it is usually in Punjab, and I'm saying that's in Punjab, it's basically from South Punjab. To secure our children or the women or the girls, we need to make washrooms for these people in this society. And then he said in his presentation that more than 43,000 kids die every year due to stunting. And it has again to do with the cleanliness. And we thought that on a mother feed, how come a child can have stunting? But it is actually this unhygienic problem. So when we are starting all this program, I'm here. You said that we hope that we do understand. Trust me, now we do understand. It's a new government who talks about things. It does not talk about metro and oranges and those buses and flying rickshaws. We talk about human investment. And human investment is about all this wash, clean water, hygiene, and sanitation. These are the basics which we need to work. And I hope that this program start with me, with from South Punjab and my area, Dera Ghazi Khan. Because I told you policies are there, but we need implementation. Without implementation, it will be just a cliche. It will just be another beautiful policy. But now we should work practically for this Pakistan. And for that, I'm always there. You can always call me. I always go and I always tell to the people, these are not those ministers or prime minister who needs a lots of protocols and monies and things to facilitate. These are the minister who can come from their office walking here and make a speeches and then they can go. We're so easy. We're so open. You can come anytime. You can take advantage. We'll go. I'm your face. You can use our ministry. We want to work with you practically. I'm already very proud of my ministry. Though its name was 3-time change, though its domain was challenged every time after 18th amendment, we have lots of problems. As again, Mr. Thieu said that when we are dealing with a lot of, there are overlapping. We don't know with whom to do. It is just because we are very good with lame excuses in Pakistan. We just want to shift our responsibility onto another one. If you go to the minister, they'll say, gee, it's a... because I'm the one who has to answer every time in Senate and in National Assembly. Every time I stand there, it's a devolved subject after 18th amendment. It's not our domain. But unfortunately, it's international law. For international law, you have to work with the ministry, which is actually the capital territory. So we are again working on our ministry for our domain, for our rights, for our expansion. And we are going to talk, all you people are here from your provinces. You are actually the people who are going to take all these things from there and you are going to implement there. And even in Balochistan, even in Sindh, in Punjab, in KPK, all my roots, all my student life, it's all been roaming around in all this Pakistan. I just love this country. It's my romance to be in this country. If Pakistan is here, and inshallah it will be here till the end of this world, Pakistan will be here. But we cannot live here without doing nothing, just making cliches. Practically, we have to prove ourselves that we are good citizens. वो जो हमेशा कहते हैं पाकिस्तान ने मुझे दिया क्या है, फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम लेट्स क्वेश्चन आवर सेल्फ व्हाट वी गिव टू पाकिस्तान. एंड पाकिस्तान इज स्टिल स्टैंडिंग, पाकिस्तान नीड्स अस, एवरी वन ऑफ अस. सो लेट्स लव पाकिस्तान, लेट्स लव आवर सेल्फ, लेट्स लव दिस SDGs. आई जस्ट लाइक माई मिनिस्ट्री, पीपल यूज़ टू से व्हाई वुड यू बिकम अ मिनिस्टर ऑफ क्लाइमेट चेंज, नाउ आई फील व्हाई आई एम हेयर. सो थैंक यू अगेन, आई एम थैंकिंग द मीडिया हु आर ऑल हेयर. Because whatever he says, if you do not project, nobody will know that. So thank you the media, thank you my ministry, thank you all of the officials, thank you UNICEF and the SDGs, all the good brains, all the people from provinces, ladies and gentlemen. Let's make this program very successful, and wherever you need my ministry, wherever you need me, I'll be there to help you, to lead you, and to work with you, and walk beside you. Pakistan Zindabad. Thank you.